Hello, everybody. It's Matt, and I'm the author of Conversations in the Paint Department, which talks about my journey through divorce over the past 2 years. Now, have you ever thought about the power and the significance of dates? I mean, we all have dates that hold significance for us. Some of us, you know, December 25th is coming up. That's Christmas. We remember birth dates and anniversaries. And so there's a certain level of happiness that it brings. But then there's dates that bring sadness, maybe shame, despair, anger, the date that a loved one passed away, or in my case, the date when a marriage fell apart. See, on November 22nd, 2017, that's a date I'll always remember because it was a day that I came home day before Thanksgiving to spend time with my family, and I found an empty house and a note on the table. And that note basically said that my ex-wife didn't want to be married anymore. That piece of paper held so much shame and so much weight in my life for the past 2 years. Shortly after reading that piece of paper, I fell into this anger and this resentment, and I would point the finger about my ex-wife when I found out some of the choices that she had made and the real reason why she left. It hurt. It really hurt. It damaged my ego. And then what happened was I fell into a period of sadness and depression for quite some time. And I wanted to get out of that, and so I got out of that by thinking that another person would make me happy. And so I tried the dating scene, and boy, was that a disaster. I was a complete mess. And see, what started to happen was this letter started to remind me of all the shame, all the secrets, all of the things that I had going on in my life that I just couldn't be honest about. And so over the next few months, I started really looking at what was the 50% of the marriage that I messed up? What did I do? And I'm still working on that even today because I don't want to repeat those mistakes, but geez, I mean, I was selfish. I was arrogant. I was concerned about myself, concerned about my career, didn't care about anybody else. I wanted to talk and not listen. I blamed other people. I held resentments. I just held the bar so high and I expected people to serve me instead of serving other people. And so over time, I've started to really realize that I need to work on me. And I started to really get help from other people, get help through prayer and meditation and just writing things out. But isn't it funny how just when you're growing, that all of a sudden that there's some reminders of shame that pop up? See, the other day, I realized that, oh my gosh, the 2 year mark is coming up. And it was about that same time that I got a message on Facebook from a person who used to know me and was a friend of my ex-wife as well. And this person had found out about something that happened to my family, wanted to check on us, see that we were okay. But then they also sort of started bringing up things that were said about me by my ex-wife. Things that, well, maybe were half truths. Some of it was true, and most of it was completely fabricated. And so I sat there and I was resentful. I was resentful at this person. I was resentful at my ex-wife. I was angry and I wanted to point the finger, and then I took a deep breath and I realized that I gotta own it. I gotta own the fact that I can't change the way that other people think of me. I can't change what happened, and I can't change how I acted in the past. A couple days later, I was doing this 30-day feedback challenge, and so one of the tasks on day two is to send out a survey just to get information from people on 5 adjectives that they could use to describe you. And so I was looking for positive, negative, and neutral feedback, and I made sure that I specifically sent it to people that I knew that were friendly, but also weren't my biggest fans. And so I specifically sent out a survey to people in my organization that are not big fans of me. And I got some pretty harsh feedback. I got that I was arrogant, that I'm aloof, that I'm conceited. And you know what? Yeah, I am. I am, I own it. At times I really am. And see, that's the beauty of being human, is that we are not very perfect. And so every day we have a choice, is that we can either grow bitter or we can grow better, and I know I've said that. And when we grow bitter, we look at those mistakes, we look at that piece of paper that is that letter saying you don't want to be married, or that note on Facebook that says this is what you did, or that survey of information that people really think about you, and well, we begin to feel shame and we begin to feel anger and resentment. Or we could use it to grow better. And so I looked at that feedback the other day and I thought, you know what? Thank you. In all sincerity, thank you for that feedback, because you're right. There have been times where I've been arrogant, and there are times still that I'm arrogant. And I need to work on that. And so I started diving into, well, why am I like that? And I've found that, you know, a lot of times I'll reject other people before they reject me because of insecurities. Insecurities from my past, my childhood. And I also thought about the power of that note. See, that note on November 22nd, 2017, that was something that I viewed negatively. And then the other day, I decided to pull out that note again and read it. And I read it and I actually had to laugh, because it has no power over me anymore. See, what was said about you and what a person thought about you and the way that you were rejected by that person, or you're continuing to go through that rejection, has nothing to do with your identity. It's one person's opinion of you. You are more than somebody's words. You are more than what they think. And so use this as an opportunity to grow, to get better. Yeah, I've made a lot of mistakes, and well, I own it. And a lot of this negative feedback has been great for me, because it allows me to own the 50% of my marriage and the 50% of my relationships and the 50% of my relationships at work that I've screwed up. I've lost a lot of trust from people. I've hurt a lot of people. I've taken advantage of a lot of people. I've been arrogant, inconsiderate. I've talked trash about other people. I've been jealous of other people. But you know what? It's okay. And so one of the things that I'm learning is that you have to be okay with the mistakes you've made. You have to be. You can't allow them to be like a tattoo on your skin that is always going to be there for the rest of your life. You know, I think about the Will Smith movie, 7 Pounds, and how he lived with the burden of killing 7 people by his actions. And so he needed to punish himself. And so at the end of the movie, he commits suicide, and he lines up 7 people that can use 7 different parts of his body to make their lives better. And I think sometimes we think that we have to sacrifice ourselves because we're trying to punish ourselves, but that's not what we're meant to do. We're supposed to learn, we're supposed to move on, and we're supposed to grow and get better. One of the things that I found was about a year ago at this time, my uncle had passed away. My uncle was an amazing guy. He's my dad's twin brother, and just an amazing, amazing guy. And one of the things I found out was that he was dying of stage 4 cancer, and he was helping other people. Other people were on his mind. In fact, he would even deliver Meals on Wheels. And so I found myself wanting to honor his memory by going and delivering Meals on Wheels. And so I started doing that. And what started happening is I started looking for opportunities to help other people. Now, I'm not quite there yet, and I'm not some Mother Teresa or great person. I'm pretty screwed up at times, but this has given me the momentum that I need to be moving in the right direction. And some days it's 2 steps forward, 5 steps back, and other days 1 step forward and 30 steps back, but you're moving in the right direction. Find ways that you can get outside of yourself, because that's where true healing takes place. You know, the other thing too is you need to really think about letting go. And it's kind of a weird concept, because the other day when that person rattled off all that stuff, I had so many resentments creep up towards my ex-wife. And so I responded back to that person saying, you know what, I don't remember doing some of these things, but you know what, I've kind of moved on. I'm not going to say anything negative about my ex-wife. It's just not worth it. I've moved on, and I've forgiven her. Doesn't mean I like what happened. It doesn't mean like I like what she's doing and how she's living her life, but I'm done judging. I'm done being resentful. But what's funny about that is that as soon as you let go of one resentment, some other types of resentments creep up. And so I've really had to take an honest look at myself of why in the world am I so resentful? And see, when I start thinking that everything's about me, That's when I become resentful. When I get outside of myself and I help other people, that's when resentment doesn't seem as bad. And the other thing too is, you know, think about ways that you can improve your life. Use this as a time to really become more well-rounded. I've used this time to do things that I never thought I would do in my life, learn things and grow in ways that I could actually benefit other people. So I learned how to swim. I didn't know how. I learned how to wood carve and ballroom dance and all sorts of different things. In fact, I'm even going axe throwing. I don't know how that's going to help somebody, but it's going to be darn fun. And so find ways that you can grow, even if it's just one time a month, and it doesn't necessarily have to be with money. It could be connecting with other people, learning from other people. In fact, I've surrounded myself with a group of guys who have kind of gone through some things that I've went through. And we talk on a weekly basis, and I make sure that I contact them every single day. And I tell you what, learning from their stories, learning from their mistakes, and sharing my stories and sharing my mistakes has been one of the most valuable things that I could ever imagine. I've grown a lot over the past couple months especially, but I'm gonna continue to grow because of other people. You don't need to do life on your own. And then last but not least, you know, get it out. Get it out. Talk about what's going on. Talk about that, the struggles that you have. But be careful with who you confide to. See, there are a lot of people out there that cloak themselves as helpful people, but are just using it for gossip or personal gain. Unfortunately, I've had a lot of people in particular who were interested in me, but for other reasons, like they wanted something from me, or they wanted to show sympathy and date me or something like that. And as soon as you show that, no, I'm not interested in that, they go away. So be careful with who you confide to. I highly recommend that you try to find somebody of the same gender, that you try to find somebody who is has integrity, somebody who might be in a reputable position, like a pastor, a counselor of some sort. But get it out. Whether you write it out, whether you talk it out, whether you run it out, get it out. And finally, last but not least, you know what? Take care of you. When your body and your mind and your spirit are healthy and you're okay, you can take care of other people. I remember early on in my divorce feeling so overwhelmed. And somebody saying to me, if you were on a plane and the cabin lost air pressure and the mask, oxygen mask falls down, you need to put it on your face first before you can help other people. Because if you're losing air and you can't breathe, how are you supposed to help somebody else? And so if we don't take care of ourselves, we can't help other people. And so it's really important for you to find some ways to help yourself, and whether you're going through a stressful time period or whether you're not. But I just really encourage you to do that. You will get through this. 2 years have come and gone as fast as I've ever seen it go. And I've experienced so much hurt, so much pain, so much embarrassment, so much resentment, so much anger, but I've also experienced a lot of joy. I've experienced a lot of happiness, a lot of contentment, a lot of forgiveness, a lot of grace. And it's on the other side. You just have to look for it, and you have to just let go, and it's there. So I want to just encourage you, don't give up. Don't give up. Allow this to be an opportunity to help you grow. Thanks, guys.